Hey my beautiful angels, it's Josie, and in this video, I want to share with you 5 magical things that you can do during the time of the full moon. It's a full moon is truly, truly magical, and you can manifest anything. The first thing to do during the time of the full moon is to manifest something very quickly. Perhaps you need some cash, you need some urgent money. This is a really good time for you to do it, to manifest it, to make things happen quickly, to make decisions happen quicker. The full moon gives you the energy. It gives you the intensity. Now, there are many rituals, and one of my favorites, if you want to manifest money, is to actually connect with the moon. The moon is the manifester. The moon has the energy and power to manifest. So when you engage your own subconscious mind, when you connect to the moon with the right intention, things really manifest, because moon in its fullness and its power, it's going to give you the energy for manifestation. Okay, so let's say you want to manifest money. Think lunar energy and silver coming together. If you have any dimes, any of these silver coins, remember, a lot of these rituals are very symbolic, but your subconscious mind responds best to symbols. So when you have silver coins, just say a prayer, hold the coins in your hand, connect with the moon, open up and say a prayer, connect with lunar energy for manifestation, saying, I'm so happy, money's coming, money is mine, and feel like you already have the money that you want. Having that silver energy, silver money energy in your hand, really connecting to the moon, feeling like all the money in the universe are yours right now, feeling good, nothing is missing from your life, everything you want is here and now. When you connect to the moon, you manifest things so much quicker. It really works. Okay, so the second thing you can do during the full moon is to heal, especially healing on the energy level, healing off emotions, uplifting yourself, healing your body. What you can do, you can charge water, just have a clean glass of water, glass container, and leave it under the direct moonlight. And ask the moon, ask the universe for healing. And imagine like lunar energy, lunar light magically charges the water. And then do a meditation, maybe a clearing ritual. Take a bath, relax, feeling so good. And then go outside, look at the moon, and see how the moon is so beautiful and bright, and then feel that moon in your body. Thank the moon, thank the universe for healing, and then drink water. Imagine like lunar energy is in every cell of your body. You're healing on the inside. And now you're glowing with beautiful moonlight. This is not just happening within your imagination. This is really happening in real life. Connect with the moon. You are healing. Number 3, another magical thing for you to do during the time of the full moon is to charge your crystals. Now, I have so many crystals. I'm crystaholic. I don't know how to say this word. Is this a word? Crystaholic? So I have many, many, many different crystals. I collect the big ones, the small ones. I have the ones that I love absolutely. I feel very connected to these crystals. And some crystals, you know, they're fine, they're beautiful, but I don't have the emotional connection. And let me tell you, there are a couple of crystals that I have been holding on for years, for literally 10 years. And these crystals are my comfort rocks. I really feel good. In moments when I'm off, when I'm out of balance, I can just hold a crystal. And then the power of the crystals, like speaking to me, Chosie. We're here, we're with you. I'm like, yes, thank you. Thank you, crystals. I can trust you. I feel so connected with you. So please, crystals, under the direct moonlight. And then, because they become kind of your friends, it may sound really ridiculous. How can stones be friends? Stones are conscious. Charge your crystals under the moonlight. Simply place them outside or on your window and leave them. And let the moonlight, powerful lunar energy, charge these crystals. Carry them with you wherever you go for anything that you desire. They're listening to you, and you charge them with powerful lunar energy. All right, so number four, another thing that you can do, the magical thing that you can do during the time of the full moon, is to do energy clearing. Now, if you have a specific tool like a bell or a drum, if you have smudging equipment, if you have like a sage or Palo Santo, and if you like to do all kinds of clearing rituals, full moon is the best. Again, because of its intensity. If you have a strong intention to do anything during the time of the full moon, it's going to be magnified. And the moon is going to help you. It's going to show you a way. So what I love to do is to clear my home, is to do some kind of a ritual that is going to help me, you know, feel better in my own space. I would smudge my house with Palo Santo, playing really good music, playing some happy music. I'll go around just smudging and just feeling good, feeling connecting with the spirit world. And this is really good, especially during the time of the full moon. Many of these magical energies are really there to help you and to serve you. If you need any energy clearing for your body, for your home, be sure to try these clearing rituals. And finally, number five, another magical ritual that you can do around the time of the full moon is to do a ritual of bathing, connecting with the element of water. Think of water as a healing element, as the life-giving substance. Essence of life is water. And you can swim in natural body of water, such as a lake or an ocean, specifically during the time of the full moon, feeling really connecting with the element of water, feeling water on your skin, just like it's life-giving energy, putting that life-giving energy into your body, feeling it on your skin. This is so, so powerful. You're charging your body. You're giving your body the vitality, youthfulness, energy. And if you don't have natural water, you can just simply take a bath. Place a few drops of your favorite essential oils in the tub. And then put some candles and make it a ritual. It's not just like you taking another bath. This is a ritual. And now this is full moon, maybe some kind of like a meditation with drumming, shamanic sounds. And then imagine like this magical water is healing you, is making you younger and happier in every way. So it works like magic. Here you go, guys, the five things for you to do during the time of the full moon. In the comments below, let me know what kinds of rituals you're doing around the time of the full moon and how you are going to use these tools to manifest the life of your dreams.